Hey everybody. So I want to talk today about this particular research paper, Adaptation of Agentic AI. And it caught my eye quite honestly, just because it's put out by like seemingly every single research institution in the United States, like Stanford, Princeton, Harvard, UC Berkeley, Georgia, UCSD. I'm leaving some off there. And then so within that, it's amazing research paper overall, right? And there's a lot that I want to talk about and break down with this research paper overall. Starting off with what exactly does this research paper do? Why should you read it overall, etc., right? This research paper, so like if someone came to me like today, whether it's in an academic setting, for personal use, for business, etc., right? Like a developer, and they're like, I want to learn agentic AI from the ground up. Where do I start? I just say, hey, here you go. This research paper is 100% for you, right? And then this research paper essentially says that there's four frameworks that exist with regards towards current agentic frameworks. That like every single agentic model that exists currently falls under one of these four frameworks. And I agree with that. I mean, it's hard to disprove like every research institution ever, right? But so within that, there's like and there the separation is essentially like what exactly is being trained. And then so you see A1 and A2 and T1 and T2, and that separation is agent one, agent method one, agent training method two, and then a tool training method one, tool training method two. And then the breakdown between these four methods beyond that is how exactly like what the reward signal is. And I'll dive deeper into this, but so in A1 it's a tool execution signal, so like what like the tool is the reward. Whereas in A2, it's agent output signal, meaning like the model's like success, right? Like its environment, and then going through everything like that, so that becomes the signal. Whereas T1 agent agnostic, it means that you're just like the tool is what gets adapted, and the model is just staying the same, right? So you just wrap all these tools around it, like tool world, things like that. I'll dive deeper into that. Right, and then you have T2, which is agent supervised frameworks, which is specifically like wrapping tools around like and for specific agents, so like sub agent as a tool and agentic memory, things like that. And I'll dive into all of these deeper, but I want to dive deeper into the concepts that this research paper lays out. And then so they lay out a link to their GitHub repository here. And then so when I click on and we go to the repository, it starts off with the same overview that they gave us here. And then they give us this like a cool development timeline, right? And then to me, this is like the really cool timeline overall, because like it's to me 100% accurate, right? And then like of course, and but so if you've like I've been following everything since this period, right? Since Toolformer, but Toolformer wasn't publicly released. Like Toolformer wasn't like they didn't release the code. It was all like developed by Meta, right? And but all internal. And you see right before March of 2023, and then so Toolformer is like released as a framework, but only internal within Meta. And then like right after this, like basically like right in like that 2 week period, then that's when the llama model leaks, like the initial llama model, right? And then you have Gorilla and Trice here, but to me the main one is Gorilla. And then so Gorilla is like the very first model that like it is like thought to solve agentic frameworks overall. They 100% open source it, and then like all the people that develop it, they get like inducted into Microsoft like immediately, right? Like Microsoft essentially like they're UC Berkeley researchers. That's why like there's a UC Berkeley behind the Gorilla there, because they're the ones that invented Gorilla, right? And you see a lot of Stanford here. I think that's Indiana IU. I could be wrong, but so Purdue. So you see like the there's a lot of academic research and involvement within these papers, right? And so that's the first place, or I guess the second place that I want to dive into within these research papers. So this period, right, going back in time, we're back to this 2023, right? And so this time, and essentially there's a lot of like choices that like anyone needs to make within that in terms of like being a researcher, et cetera. Like if you're starting to dive deep into AI in this period, you have to make some decisions. And then so decision number one within in this and around this time is like, are you in like the big five camp? So like Meta, OpenAI, Google, etc. Or are you in like the academic camp, right? And that is a big important and schism that comes out within this and from jump within all of this, right? And there's a lot of people that like they jump immediately and they jumped immediately, and I think a lot of people still gravitate immediately towards corporations having a big advantage over academia when it comes to this research overall. But like all like these charts, and there's a lot of them, right? And these research papers, etc., right? These different charts, and we go into if you understand how this is playing out, like there's less, like here's Microsoft, here's Mistral, right? But there's a majority of these OpenAI, but a majority of these are academic institutions. Like academic institutions are more represented on this development timeline than any of the corporations, right? And that's universal across the board with all AI research, period, right? And like I think like so I am often very much like very quick to knock academia overall, but I want to highlight that, right? That like I knock academia, but like I like they both suck to me just for different reasons, right? But so I had essentially like which camp do I go all in on from jump within these things? And then to me it's the corporate camp within agents, like somewhere around in like here, like in the middle of this, like here, right, like this first curve, they start getting the corporate architecture and agenda around this starts becoming like model context protocol or MCP, right? And like my editor wanted me to like focus this video heavily on MCP overall and dive into it, but then like I was going to focus this video on MCP and then utilize this paper as like a like intro or a more academic approach around it overall, but I realized like this paper is so like many leagues beyond MCP that to like put them into the same category overall would be a disservice to what exactly we're looking at overall with regards towards what they've put together here. Like, and so like what they've put together here is essentially like if you want to know, like we've been looking at this timeline since the beginning of this video, right? So this is essentially like 4 years of agentic development when it comes to AI, and then here's like literally all of the research papers that are associated with all of those developmental advancements, and then they're all here, right? Like every single one is listed out and documented here. And then so this is for reinforcement learning based methods, supervised fine tuning, and direct policy optimization methods. And then you have, it's broken out into, so that was for A1, and then for A2 systems, same thing, right? Different research papers, so methods with tools, methods without tools. And then for the T1 systems, foundational systems and architectures, categories and trainings. For the T2 system, it's all of the research papers associated essentially with all of the T2 systems. Overall, and then so if you dive into and when you dive into like the research paper itself, right, they dive deep into every single one of these methods and frameworks and then give you exactly what you need behind them overall, right? So all of the algorithms, literally, like so this research paper gives you access to all the algorithms that you would need around this, the history around agentic progression, the four overarching frameworks with regards towards how exactly agents are being optimized. Literally anything and everything that is with regards towards like agentic frameworks, how they work overall, what you should be including within them is included within this research paper, including like every single concept that I have talked about ever on this channel at some point is represented in some way in this research paper, right? They talk about very specifically the adaptation and advent of memory and how important memory is within the structure overall. And then they also talk about latent tuning and then all utilizing methods like the tool former, et cetera, that they dive very specifically into those models as essentially like latent tuning methods, and then dive deep into essentially like, again, all of the frameworks that I've laid out in this and on this channel and over the years with regards towards these things overall. And then, so again, to me, this is like the big one that to me, I always look back on as the like grandfather of all of this. To me, is the gorilla model within this, and it's like the one that I always like to highlight and represent here, as you can see early on in the research here. Right, again, it's the first one of these that was like actually released, period. Overall, so the one like actually like that you could actually like utilize to see what they were doing. More than just the math overall, right? Like actually get access to the code, which was a very significant advancement that they provided to the community overall there. But so within this, the bottom line to me is that like if you understand the advancements that have taken place within the last, we'll call it 4 years, when it comes to agents, like there hasn't been a lot of huge advancements overall, right? These four frameworks were and have been established for these 4 years, right? It's just been like different algorithms, different tunings, etc. within these four frameworks overall. And then so if you do want to get into and look into kind of what I would call like a more stable area of AI, I guess it would probably be agentic frameworks overall, because this has been relatively stable with regards towards these frameworks, and they break down all of it too, right? Everything that you would need with regards towards the different types of training methods, so supervised fine tuning, reinforcement learning with verifiable rewards, everything that you would, and like what all of these terms mean, how to implement them, what the algorithms are behind them, etc. Right? This is a beautiful research paper. Again, like it's if anyone came to me today and was like what's the best resource that you could possibly do beyond any course, beyond anything else, just point them to this research paper here put out by all of these institutions here to give you what you're looking for within that overall. And then so yeah, I think I've kind of said my piece overall with regards towards this research paper. It's super cool. Check it out. Check out the GitHub repository as well. It's easy to link from the research paper, and then it's just kind of like a deeper dive and just like kind of the better breakdown, and then also the direct links to the research papers here from the GitHub repository. And if like that's the stuff content overall, please like and subscribe. Thank you very much.